So if your reputation's been negatively affected online and you have negative links, whether they be reviews or articles, this video is going to teach you how to get those links removed or de-indexed permanently so they no longer affect your permanent record and your life is not going to be affected by it. Because we know how bad this can be for not only your personal life, but your business life, closing sales. People are going to Google you. And the best way to handle negative search results is to get them deleted for good. This video is going to teach you how to do that. And of course, if you love the content of this video, please like the video and subscribe for more. So I'm Jay, I'm one of the co-founders of Otter PR. We're one of the top growing digital agencies for public relations, crisis communications, and reputation in Florida. If you do need any further assistance with your online reputation, please contact us and we'll be happy to help. All right, so let's get into the video and teach you how to get those links de-indexed or removed permanently. And there's gonna be a lot of factors involved. I've seen cases where the New York Times has published something. And kind of the overarching theme of this is if the publication has high journalistic integrity and is one of the legacy news publications, you're gonna have a harder time getting one of those articles de-indexed or deleted. Chances are those are not gonna be defamatory articles, which means they're not going to be untrue. Remember, defamation, slander, these are things that are untrue and negative. However, if the journalistic article is true and negative, there's not gonna be much that you can do in terms of getting it removed. So here's the steps that you need to take, and here's kind of the chart where I see it working. So first we're gonna look at what are those negative articles. Are they somebody's blog? Is it a Reddit thread? Is it a review on Facebook? Those things are gonna be much easier to handle. And we do those by attacking a couple of different methods and strategies for getting those down. The first one being empathy. Asking the owner of the Reddit thread to kindly remove his thread. It's affecting your personal life, your family, your business, and all they have to do is remove it. Chances are these are good people. They're going to go ahead and take that thread down. And that's all they have to do. You're gonna contact the blog owner, you're gonna contact the reviewer, and see if you can use empathy to get that removed. If you can't, then you can use a monetary financial incentive, offering them a couple of $100 to remove that Reddit thread, to delete that blog, to delete that mugshot. And we're gonna have to kind of decide, right? After you see them, after you gauge that person, is money going to work better or is a threat going to work better? If it does include anything that is defamatory or slanderous, it is very helpful to have a lawyer in your corner to pursue a legal threat for that person. If that review or that thread does include anything that is doxing, which means it contains your personal information, or contains defamation or slander, go the legal route, make that legal threat. If it does not, you can make that monetary, you know, financial incentive to remove that article. For journalistic publications, things like your local newspaper, the New York Times, the Chicago Tribune, places where they have a real journalist doing real reporting and are likely reporting on facts, not on slander, not on defamation, they're not making things up where you can make that legal threat. The editors at those channels, the journalists also have journalistic integrity. They'd likely sign contracts that will prevent them from removing that article, from changing the article, from de-indexing the article. So there's a couple of ways that you can go about handling something like this. One is you can find a case for that article being defamatory or for that article actually harming you in a physical or mental nature. Making a case for how that has affected your mental health going forward, or affected your business liability because of it. So, also helpful to have a lawyer in your corner, and you can work with an agency like us to make that case on your behalf. That is 50% effective in a lot of cases, because we can usually find some slander, or we can find a case or a precedent for it affecting your well-being and getting that taken down. The other option that you can potentially look at is going a more black hat method. And there's a lot of services out there and contractors and freelancers out there that can actually penalize a link on Google. They do that through buying spam links, aiming towards their pornography sites, gambling sites that are all linking to this one link. And the effect of that is Google will say, there's a lot of suspicious activity looking toward that link. We're gonna de-index that while we look into it. If it's a blog or a publication that's not actively monitored, this can be effective. However, if it's something like the Chicago Tribune or the New York Times, they immediately see when something's been de-indexed and then they can de-link those spam links and you actually end up hurting your case. So again, this is can be a touchy thing and you need to know when to use it and when not to use it. Moral of the story here, if this is a lower tier blog, a review, a Reddit thread, something on Quora, that you can pretty actively contact the owner, contact the publisher, and either decide to make that financial incentive or legal threat, can be very easy to remove, especially coming from a lawyer or from a trained agency. On the other hand, if it's a publication, like a legacy publication like New York Times, or somewhere with a journalistic contract or agreement, can be a little bit more difficult, but definitely still worth trying. And we're there to help you if you need. We have lawyers on staff to make your case, whether that be a defamation threat or a threat to your mental stability. We're there to help you out with that, and it's worth it for you to go ahead and try and do it yourself and contact them before spending your money and your time working with an agency or a freelancer. But if you decide you want this done quickly and you want this done correctly, we're here to help. Anyways, I hope that was helpful for you. If you like the content of this video, please drop a heart. If you want to schedule with us to talk more about your specific case, because each case is different, we're here for you. Book a consult below in the link, and we'll be sure to talk with you soon. Okay, if you love the content of this channel, please subscribe. Please hit the bell notification for more. We're Otter PR. We're located in Florida, and we're here for all of your crisis management, reputation, or media relations needs. I'll see you in the next video.